Hi viewers, welcome to Learn MATLAB Simulink Basic. Today we are going to see about Park and Clarke transformation. Park transformation is ABC to dq0 transformation, and Clarke transformation is thing but conversion of ABC to alpha beta 0 transformation. So normally this Park and Clarke transformation used in the control system, that means for converting ABC quantity into dq0 or alpha beta. So we go for Park and Clarke. So why we go for Park and Clarke means when converting that ABC to dq0, that means it's like of conversion of AC quantity into DC quantity. In DC quantity we can control the system easily in DC quantity, right? When the control parameter are DC, so we can control easily. So that's why we go with this Park and Clarke transformation. So in MATLAB already it have some basic tool about that ABC to dq0 and dq ABC to alpha beta 0, right? So how we are going to use that tool? So just you have to type here ABC to dq0 and you will get this one, and then you can type ABC to alpha 0, right? So in order to implement this two block, right, so we need a three phase input, right? So first we need to generate three phase sine wave. So for that go to Simulink library browser and go to source and then take sine wave, right? And then you take sine wave here, and then here you can fix the amplitude and frequency. Here I'm going to take the frequency is 2 pi f, that means 2 pi 50 hertz, and I'm going to make phase angle here is 0, and then I'm going to make the phase angle for a second phase. So here I'm going to take minus 120 divided by 360 into 2 into pi. So we are, that means the phase angle should be given radian, so that's why we are taking this like this. Okay, the degree going to be converted into phase angle, and then for third phase you are going to take the phase angle is 120 divided by 360 into 2 pi. Okay, and then I'm going to take max to combine these three inputs. So I'm going to combine this. So here you can see that this is ABC to dq0 and ABC to alpha beta 0. So in ABC to dq0, right, so we need to provide two inputs. So one is three phase input, another one is omega t, right? So the omega t can be generated by means of another tool, nothing but a phased lock loop, right? So just you type PLL, here you can see that PLL three phase. Just you have to use that PLL three phase and then connect this three phase input. So here we need to use only omega t. So I'm going to use go to block and then I'm going to change this one to omega t, and then I'm going to use another go to block to connect this three phase sine wave. So here I'm going to make va vc. Okay, and then these two will be used for conversion, right? That means ABC to dq0 and ABC to alpha beta 0. So I'm going to take this one as input. So second input will be taken here. I'm going to connect this one. So here I'm going to connect the input to this block. So this block known as ABC to dq0, that means Park transformation. This one nothing but the Clarke transformation. Okay. So next, here you can click PLL. So just you have to change the initial frequency to 50 hertz here. Okay, and then apply and click OK. So next you have to measure the output. So for that I'm going to use scope. So here I'm going to use three input scope. That means we are going to measure three inputs. So one is output from the ABC to dq0 and output from the ABC to alpha beta 0. and then another one is nothing but input. Okay, so here I am used the time, that when total simulation time is 0.1, and then here we consider the amplitude which is equal to 1. Okay, so now I am going to simulate this model. So before that I am going to make 3 layout to scope, right? I am going to change the layout. So here I am going to simulate this one. So now we consider this is an input, right? 3-phase input, and then this is the output of dq0. Okay, so I'm going to change the label VABC, and then this is nothing but VDQ0, and this is nothing but V alpha beta 0. Okay, V alpha beta 0. Okay, so here you can see that, right, this 3-phase sine wave is converted in DC quantity by means of a ABC to dq0 conversion. That is nothing but a Park transformation, right? And then the 3-phase quantity converted into 2-phase quantity, so by means of a ABC to alpha beta 0 transformation, nothing but a Clarke transformation. So we are converting a 3-phase quantity into DC quantity in case of Park, and then 2-phase quantity in the case of Clarke transformation. Okay, so next you have to use the inverse concept, right? Inverse Park and inverse Clarke transformation. So for that, just you have to type here dq0 to ABC, and then alpha beta 0 sequence to ABC. Okay, so this 2 will be used for inverse Park and inverse Clarke transformation. So I am going to use the output of this Park transformation when we input for this inverse Clarke transformation. The output from the Clarke transformation will be this input for that this block, inverse Clarke transformation block. And then omega t you have to take from here, and then you can connect here. And then I am going to use another 2 more inputs. So I am going to use 5 inputs, and then I am going to make this one. That means the fourth will be the output of inverse Park transformation block. So the fifth one is the output of inverse Clarke transformation block. Okay, so next I am going to simulate this model. Here you can see that, so this is your input, and then this is output of Park transformation. So that nothing but ABC to dq0 conversion. So this is the output of Clarke transformation, that mean ABC to alpha beta 0. Now I am going to simulate this one. So here we are going to measure the, that mean inverse output, right? Inverse Park transformation output, and here we are measuring inverse Clarke. Okay, so actually this output should be equal to our input, right? We have to check that one. Now you can see that the output of inverse Park and inverse Clarke, right? So it will be equal to our input, right? So whatever we transfer from our input ABC to dq0 and alpha, so again it will be converted to ABC by means of inverse Park transformation, inverse Clarke transformation. So that means this kind of concept you can use in the inverter control logic. Okay, and then it can be used in the motor control logic. So when you have to convert this ABC to dq0 and alpha, right, that control system, that means we can easily control the system, we can easily tune the system. Okay, so for that purpose only we are using this kind of transformation. Okay, so thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.